of the spherical harmonic, the orthonormality relations for this spherical harmonic. And also, we can expand this 1 over r, the inter-electronic repulsion terms in the Hamiltonians treated as perturbation. We can expand this in terms of spherical harmonics. Okay. Substituting this into this equation, and this as well, the spherical harmonic, substitute this into this equation, 1 over r, and using this orthonormality relations, okay, we can show here the first order energy correction. Okay, can be expressed like in this form. And using this range, okay, the definitions of this R, these two R here, you can show the E1 here, okay, is given by this form. Okay, with charge and the Z value here, you can show the first order energy correction is 34.01. Okay, the tutorial here, you can solve this integral also using this table integrals. Okay, in this appendix, you can use this table integrals. Okay, this just to shows, okay, the beauty of quantum mechanics. Okay, using all the tools, mathematical tools, to solve the integrals, to get the energy corrections, and to approximate our energy, okay, for the ground state of helium. Okay, so I will be uploading this, okay, these tutorials, and you can do this, okay, and we can discuss this next week. Now we are going to here to continue our lecture on constructing the energy diagrams. Okay, this energy diagram. Okay, let's say here I want here to take this part, okay, of this diagram, 1s, 2s state. Okay. Now we are going to write a complete anti-symmetric wave functions corresponding to this two state. Okay, this two state. So the spatial part, we know, okay, the spatial part of this state, okay, the spatial parts of the orbital or the wave functions is given by this anti-symmetrics, spatial orbital or the spatial wave functions, 1s. Okay, the anti-symmetrics. From the solutions of 2x2 circular block diagonal matrix, okay, we also have seen the definitions of Pauli principles for the indistinguishable identical particles, and we can write these four possible spin functions, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four possible two electron spin functions. Now we are going to use this, okay, all these possible spin functions, two electron spin function. To write a complete wave functions corresponding to this two state, energy state, these two energy state, this one and this one. So because this is the anti-symmetric spatial orbitals, in order to get the complete wave functions, we must combine this with symmetric spin functions. Okay, now we have here a triply degenerate levels. Okay, for this complete three here, 1, 2, 3. Correct zero order wave functions, which satisfy the anti-symmetric properties of these two electrons, fermions electrons, with respect to the electrons interchange between two different orbitals. Okay, so here we have this three anti-symmetrics wave functions, complete wave functions, and all these three anti-symmetrics, okay, are zero order, the correct zero order wave functions. taking here into account the linear combination, this zero order wave function, this zero order wave function, this also zero wave function, and this is a zero order wave function, this is zero order wave function, and this also the zero order wave functions. So the linear combination of this zero order function, we have corrected this, okay, giving this a complete anti-symmetric wave functions. So we have here triply degenerate state having same energy here, and the energy here, we know the zero order here, sum of this zero order with E1 and E1 here, the first order energy corrections here has two component of energy, J1S, 2S and K1S, 2S. For the next excited state here, okay, this one, we only can get here one non-degenerate state. The symmetric partial wave function here combining with the anti-symmetric wave function, to get a complex anti-symmetric wave functions for these two identical fermions electron. Okay, this as well is an anti-symmetric wave functions, okay, for these two electrons. Now we are going to, okay, you can refer the many electron chapter, okay, this chapter of many electron atoms. And Slater, okay, pointed out that this, what we call this, anti-symmetric wave functions can be right in terms of determinants, can be right here in terms of determinants. So Slater devised this determinants, and these determinants has spin orbitals as matrix elements. The matrix element inside the slat, the determinants, okay, the determinant is called Slater determinants, is actually spin orbitals. Like in these examples, okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 anti-symmetric functions. We can write this, wave functions actually in terms of this Slater determinants. The first row here of this determinant represent the first electrons. With spin alpha, electrons 1 occupies 1 s state with spin alpha, or electron 1 occupies 2 s state with spin alpha, and electron, the second row here, okay, represent this second electron. Electron 2 occupies 1s state with spin alpha, or electron 2 occupies 2s state with spin alpha. Okay, expanding this circular, this determinants, okay, the circular determinant, so we get this one. We also can write this, okay, the simplest form of this determinant here. Okay, so we write here just simply like this. One S, two S. The unbar here is for the spin alpha, where we absorb already here 1/√ here. Okay, which is the number 1/ here, √(n), factorials. And here is the number of electrons in the atoms. And this as well, you can write here simply this coefficients V here, already absorb this coefficient into this determinant. So for this second anti-symmetric wave functions, okay, we can simply write like this, using this bar notations for the spin beta. Okay, 1s beta, 2s beta, 1s beta, 2s beta. So we get this one. And about this one, this is the linear combination of two determinants. Okay, linear combination of these two determinants, which is 1 over square root of 2 the first determinants is 1s electron occupies in 1s or electron 2 occupies in 1s with spin alpha, or electron 1 occupies in 2s with spin beta. Okay. Or electron 1 here occupies this 1s orbital with spin beta, or electron 1 occupies spin 2s state with spin alpha. Okay, and electron 2 also occupies, this is the 2 by 2 matrix, like this one, like this one. Electron 2 here occupies in 1s with spin alpha, electron 2 occupies 2s with spin beta, or electron 2 occupies 1s with spin beta, or electron 2 occupies 2s state here with spin alpha. So we'll get this linear combinations of two determinants. And this state, okay, the difference here is only here, sine plus here. This minus here, plus minus. This one. So now you can see this energy. We can evaluate these integrals. Okay, I will give this as tutorials to get this value. But the most important thing here, okay, it is more than enough. We write the components energy here for the first order energy correction in terms of J and K. This J and K explains, okay, physically how their two electron interacts. Okay. So this is J, how we can evaluate this J. For example, J1S to S, K1S to S, from these integrals. From this integral. Okay, we can evaluate these integrals. Okay, so I will leave this as exercises, okay, to evaluate this J and K, okay, to get this value. You can get easily this zero order energy, this zero order energy, okay, from this one. Okay, without taking into account the intermonic repulsions, all this zero order are degenerate. Okay. And energy is given by this negative 68 electron volt. So this is the negative 68 point something here electron volt. So we can evaluate each of these integrals, okay? The J, the Coulomb integrals to give this Coulomb energy, the Action integral will give the Action energy. Action energy is the is due to the inter-electronic repulsions, okay, so interchange of electrons, okay, due to the interchange of electrons between two different orbitals. So we can write here, okay, this two electron here for helium, we have this nucleus and two electrons. These first electrons, okay, could be here in 1s state. Electron 2 here could be in 2s state. Or electron 1 could be here in 2s state. And electron 2 in 1s state. Because of this indistinguishabilities of these two electrons, okay, it produces this energy. Okay, these effects of interchange of the two electrons generate this energy, this action energy. Okay, so the classical effect here is only the electrostatic repulsion here of these two same charge of electron density. So this is the classical effects. They are resulting in this Coulomb energy. Coulomb energy. Now, we are going here to describe the angular momentum here, each of this state. Okay, each of this state. Because we know the angular momentum, the total angular momentum's operator, sorry, the total angular momentum quantum number is a good quantum number, which can be measured simultaneously with energy. This energy. This energy. Okay. Quantum mechanically, the operator, okay, the Hamiltonian operator commutes with the total angular momentum's operator. total angular momentums of these two individuals' angular momenta, lateron 1 and 2. Okay. The individual's angular momentums for each electron 1 and 2. The quantum number for these two electrons, angular momentum quantum number for these two electrons are not good quantum number. So we cannot measure, we are not able to measure simultaneously the properties of these two angular momenta, electron 1 and 2, with its energy. This energy, the total energy here. Okay, we are only able to measure simultaneously this physical quantity, the total and only, the totals angular momentums. Okay, both the orbitals, the total orbital and the total spin, angular momentums. Where mathematically or quantum mechanically can be proven here through these commutator relations. Okay, they commute, okay, to each other here, and the commutator here give zero. Okay, we can evaluate this, the total angular momentums operator here. The total angular momentum operator here, okay, the square, okay, which I mean the square, will give the magnitudes of the total angular momentums. Okay. Now, we are going to see here, okay, this aspect of angular momentums. Angular momentum theory, okay, is a huge subject in both physics and chemistry. You can find in literature, in physics and chemistry. Chemists or physicists, okay, developed this angular momentum theory since the early quantum mechanical angular momentum theory since the early 19th century. So the angular momentum here, you can refer this, okay? In your notes, okay, under this section's addition of angular momentums. Okay, we have done discussing this Slater determinant. Okay. And this Slater determinant is always anti-symmetric. It's always anti-symmetric. Okay, interchange of these columns or row will change the signs of this wave functions, meaning that, okay, these changes, okay, is actually when we interchange these two electrons, 1 and 2, or 2 and 3, between two different orbitals. So this is the 3x3, the lithium Slater determinants. So now, okay, we are going to look this additions, angular momentums, angular momenta. Okay, how we add this individual angular momentums. So generally we can draw the vector okay. like this vector. Let's say this is the vector of orbital or spin angular momentums. Orbital or spin angular momentum. You learn this in physical 1 and physical 2. Couples with another vector. And this, okay, second vector is also the orbital or the spin. So the coupling here, okay, could be between orbital and orbitals, spin and spin, angular momentums vector, or orbital with spin, or spin with orbitals. So you learn in physical 1 and physical 2 this notation. This vector for orbital angular momentums, this for the vector for spin angular momentums. In this course, okay, just to differentiate the totals with the individual angular momentums, okay, we use this small L instead of this capital L, or small here S with this capital S. Capital S is for the total spin. This is for the total orbital. So this could be here L2 or S2. And this is the L1 or S1. Okay, the coupling here will give this M, the total one. Okay, so L or S. Okay, you learn in physical 1 and physical 2. Let's say for here, you can draw the vector diagram for this L. Sorry. Ada problem lah, disconnect. Ayo. Okay. Hello. Hello. Boleh dengar ke? Can you hear me? Hello.
Yes, bro.
Can you see this slide?
No, you are not presenting.
You must grant permission in order to screen share. What? Okay. Okay, now we have the angular momentums. Here you learn in physical 1 and 2. You can draw the vector diagram here. Okay. This vector diagram. Okay. Let's say your z-axis is your reference axis. This is one of the electron here. So the L here, angular momentum's vector here. So the magnitude here of this angular momentum's, okay. This is the magnitude of angular momentums. And the Z components lies on this axis, along this Z axis. Okay. Because of this quantum number, the angular momentums, okay, here is quantized, and also is the components of these angular momentums. We only can determine only one of these component of this vector, okay? We are not able to determine all the three components of this vector. Only one of this vector. So that's why this vector, okay, rotating here around this axis. Because we cannot assign this, the other two components here, the y and the x. Okay, the vector could be here at this point, or 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 this point. So this is how we write the vector diagram for orbitals angular momentums. For the spin, angular momentums, the only we have here two components. Okay, where here is negative h bar and this positive half h bar for the spin. So the spin as well the magnitude here. For the electrons, okay, the s here is half. So the component of the spin ms, okay, there are two possibilities of this component of spin, component of this vector, positive half and negative half. And m here depends on this l. Okay, we know this m is negative l 0 to l. Okay, now we have here coupled these two individual angular momentums, L1 and L2, to get this the total angular momentums. Okay, we know each of these. Okay, the angular momentum quantum number here is L1, and for the spin is S1. L2. For the second electron, L2 and S2. When we couple these two angular moment, these two angular momenta, what is the total here, the quantum number for this one? We want to know here, what is the L? What is the S? Quantum number. The total spin and the total orbital angular momenta. Okay. How we are going to relate this? L, big L, big S, with this small L, small S, small L, and small s here. Okay, how are we going to relate this? Okay. As I said earlier, these two small individual here, small l and small s here, L1, L2, S1, S2 here, are not good quantum number. Okay, using the perturbations theory, okay, we can evaluate this approximate energy, two approximate energy. This triply degenerates, and this higher non-degenerate state. Okay, we obtain this two energy. This two energy is one of the physical quantities, measurable quantities, okay, can be found from the quantum mechanical calculations. Okay, we use perturbation, first order energy perturbation, to get this physical measurable energy here, quantities. We also can measure the angular momentums, okay, of these two electrons. Only the total one here can be here measured simultaneously with this energy, this total energy, not its individual's angular momentum, L2, S2, L1, L1. We cannot measure this together with this energy. Okay, so this is one of the main principles of quantum mechanics in measurings. Okay, simultaneously, the physical quantities, quantum mechanical quantities. Okay, now we want to know this, why is the L, why is the S? Okay, using the Clerche-Gordan coefficients. Okay, and get this big L, big S in term of small l and small s. Generally, we can write here as J. J here could be big L or big S. Okay, so this J is from M. Okay, so this M, this vector M, J. J here, okay, could be L or S. Big S here. This L or S, generally we can write as J. Okay, J also you can see that, okay, J is the total. Total from both spin and the both orbital. Both spin and orbitals. So this is how we want to relate here. This individual angular momenta, L1 and L2. And this as well. For the spin is S1 or the S2. So this addition angular momentum rules is very useful to construct the atomic term symbol you learn in physical, in organics, in organic chemistry. How we want to represent the state, okay? To describe the state, the angular momentums, the total angular momentums, okay, for a particular state. You learn also in spectroscopy, molecular spectroscopy and the atomic spectroscopy, okay? So the MJ here, this is MJ. Okay. This is the you learn in physical one, physical two, the individual angular momentum, orbital and spin. So now we are going to draw this vector diagram for the big L. Big L also has its components, own components. Okay, so this is M, H bar. And this one is L plus one, the magnitude. This is z-axis. Okay. You see here, what is the operator here? Okay. This one. The operator to find this magnitude, this is the square root of the eigenvalue. You learn in physical one, in physical two. Okay. This is for the L here. Let's say this is L. For small L, we are here using this small. It's the spherical harmonic. Theta and phi in term of here. Okay, as a function of theta and phi. So this is the eigenvalue. H square and y. Okay, so this is the eigenfunctions, this is the eigenvalue. The square root of this eigenvalue, this will give the magnitude of this vector. Okay, because we have here L square operator, the orbital angular momentum operator. Likewise for the spin, okay, spin operator. The square of this eigenvalue will give the magnitude of this spin vector. Okay, what is the eigenfunction for this? For the individual angular momentums, the eigenfunctions is given by the spherical harmonic. These eigenfunctions. These eigenfunctions. Okay. This eigenfunction describe the angular momentum state. Okay, of this electron. Okay, how about this total? Okay. It's no longer here. It's the eigenfunction for this total's vector here. Okay. If you want to know this, okay, you can take advanced quantum chemistry course. Okay. The eigenfunction for the total's operator, this operator. Let's say this is the operator. The L square of the Y is the total here. Okay, let's say we write here just simply like this. This is the eigenfunction for these totals. The square of this total operator here, orbital angular momentums, with its eigenvalue. This operator L square here commutes with this Hamiltonian operator for these two electron helium atom. In this example, helium So this is helium or many electron atoms, many electrons, the Hamiltonian for many electron atoms. And as well, okay, these commutation relations, the LZ also does commute here. So we can determine simultaneously with each component of this vector. Only the total components and this totals orbital and its component here, the LZ. Now, this is MJ, how we can determine the MJ. Okay. For example, here for this J2 and J3. So, we can write here, the maximum value here is 5, the minimum value here is 1. So it's from 1, 5 to 1. Okay? With increment here. Okay, not increment here from by 1. Okay? Using this angular momentum addition rules. Okay? Derived from the Clebsch-Gordan's coefficients. This one. So this is the minimum value, this is the maximum value. Okay, we have discussed this, the coupling vector, the coupling of spin. How about the Z? Is the Z is only the algebraic here summation of this M. Okay? Let's say you have these two individuals' angular momentums. When we couple this, okay, so this is the z-axis. So this is m actually for the first vector here, m1. So we have here this second vector here, this m2. We have m1, m2 is this actually the summation of this. M1 and M2 will get this total components, okay, of angular momentums. Okay. These orbitals, spin as well. This is spin. 1, this is vector diagram, okay. This, the coupling of these two vector, okay, which already shown the L, the coupling of the angular momentums. From the coupling of vector will give this coupling of angular momentums, individual angular momentum, J1, J2 here, okay. Now, yeah, you can see this diagram. Okay, half ball principle. Okay, you can read this. Now, how we are going to? Okay, please refer this note. This diagram. This diagram actually tells us everything about this chapter. We have here 1s, 2s. We also have here 1s, 2p, right? We have this, the ground state also. Let's say here, we want to look this state, okay? We already, okay? Discuss this, okay, study this state, 1s, 2s state. 1s, 2s state. So 1s to p, this is 1s to p. You can see here, these atomic term symbols. Why atomic term symbols, angular momentum is very important in quantum mechanics? Beside this energy, why this is so important? We need to assign this, each of these state. Why is the term symbols? Term symbol here tell us the totals for many electron atom. Okay, in this case, for the many electron atom, tell us the totals angular momentums. Okay, either the spin or orbital angular momentum. And these informations, okay, the totals, spin or orbitals is very important because it will determine the transitions between this energy state is allowed or not. Whether these transitions is allowed or forbidden between this state, or between from here to here, or between here to here, because of the angular momentums. Okay. This for the allowed or the forbidden transitions must satisfy or follow these rules. Okay, spectroscopy selection rules. You learn in spectroscopy. And these spectroscopy selection rules actually derive quantum can be derived quantum mechanically. Okay, just by looking at this atomic symbol, you know whether this transition is allowed or not. That's why now we are going to complete this energy diagram by assigning here each of these state. What suppose this state, its atomic term symbols. This state, what this atomic term symbols, and this microstate, what is the atomic term symbol? Okay. Okay. To derive the term symbol here, you must know the angular momentum addition rules. Okay, you seen, okay, earlier the angular momentum rules. Now we are going to determine this one. So this is the atomics, why call this spectroscopy term symbol. This is for atoms. For molecule also, you can get, okay, is the molecular term symbol. So for the S here, is for the total spin, total angular momentum obtained from the, what you call this? Angular momentum addition rules. This. This one. J here, okay, you know this might be S or L. How to derive this, you can read this, but now I want to explain this, okay, through this diagram. So 1s to s here, 1s to p here, one electron here, electron one, this, let's say this is electron one, carries this angular momentum, quantum number here as zero, this is the L2 here, the orbitals here is 1, the big L here, 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 minus 0 is still 1. So the maximum is 1, the minimum also is 1. So we only can get the L here equal 1. So using the spectroscopy here notations, for the total angular momentums, 0, 1, 2, 3, using this big S, big P, and this big D. Okay, so you can write here as P. L1, P here represent here for L1. Okay, so the spin multiplicity is 2S plus 1. What is the S now? So S here, this is S1 is half. This is S2 is half. Why is the big S? Using the angular momentum measuring rules. Half plus half is 1. The minimum value is half minus half is 0. So in between is, okay, nothing here in between for these two values. So the maximum is 1, the minimum is 0. So we can get here triplet P and singlet P. So this is singlet P and this is triplet P. Okay. Now you can see here how many degenerate state here for the triplet P. Okay, you can figure out from the perturbation calculations. We have here 1, 2, 3. Nine. This is for the PX, this is for the PY, this is for the PZ. With the antisymmetric spatial functions, orbitals, combined with the antisymmetric, combined with the symmetric spin functions. Antisymmetric spatials with the symmetric spin to get the antisymmetric wave function. This is for the PX one, this is for the PY, this is for PZ. Okay. This, we get this triply degenerate state. When we combine here the symmetric spatial orbital with the anti-symmetric spatial orbital, the anti-symmetric spin functions. This as well for the PX, PY, and PZ. So you can count here, for the triplet P here, we have here 9 degenerate state. Just here using this formula, 2L plus 1, okay, multiply with this 2S plus 1. L is 1, S is 1. So we get 9 degenerate state here, having same energy here, this energy E0 plus E1. E1 here is J plus K here. Sorry, J minus K here. So this is minus K here. j minus k. So this is 2L plus 1, 2S plus 1 here is here, we get here 3 degenerate state. So you can refer this known. This is the 9 degenerate state. This is the X for the PX, as I said. We have here the spatial anti-symmetrics with the symmetric spin function. This anti-symmetric spatial with the symmetric anti-symmetric spatial functions with the symmetric spin function to get this anti-symmetric. This is one of the p orbitals. We have another here for the py. We have another here. Okay, total up here, we have here 9 energy state, degenerate state. We also here have 3 degenerate state for the singlet P. This and the symmetric spatials with the anti-symmetric spin. This is for the PX, okay. Maybe this is PY, and this is for the PZ. Okay. Combination of this partial and spin, so we get this anti-symmetrics, a complete anti-symmetrics fermion electron. Okay. So now,
Excuse me, doctor. It's already 10:20.
Oh, sorry. Tak perasan. Let me save this first. Okay, ada persoalan. Okay, tak ada soalan? Okay, good. So, we continue next week.